And so now let's go ahead and create our new homepage. So click Add New, and it's going to give you a little bit of advice on how to use this little block editor. But I'm just gonna go ahead and get started. And what I wanna do is make my homepage. And I don't need to use any of this editor for right now. Let's just go ahead and edit with Elementor. Alrighty, so starting off, I wanna head over to my settings here on my page. And what I wanna do first is I wanna hide the title because I don't want it to say homepage. And then I also wanna switch over to the canvas layout. And that should get rid of those really big clunky images of the logo. And let's go ahead and click save options, that little down arrow, and let's go ahead and save that draft. And just to give you a quick overview of what I'm trying to set up right now, I want to create my little header here at the very top, just to include my logo and my business name. I want to create a section for my hero. So anytime somebody lands on my page, I want them to know exactly what I'm offering. I also want to add in a section of the services that this business offers. Next, I want to add in a booking section. And lastly, as a little footer for the page, I want to include general information about the location and business hours, as well as social media links. Alrighty, so with that in mind, let's go ahead and start building this. Alright, so the first thing I want to do is I want to create a brand new section. So here on the page itself, I can use this new add a new section button, or I can add a template. But let's go ahead and add a new section, and it's going to give me options for what structure I'm looking for. You can always change the structure later, but in this case, I do want to set just a one panel structure like this. And what I wanna do is I'm gonna go ahead and add an image so that I can have my little logo here at the very top, just like that. And here on my edit image panel, let's go ahead and add in the image of my logo. Alrighty, so this looks very, very big. So let's go over to the style settings, and I want to set the max width for this to, let's say, something like 50 pixels. Oh, that's a little tiny, maybe something like 75. And I think that looks good. If you look closely, what I did is I used this little dropdown to choose the units that I want to use. In this case, the PX is for pixels. You can also do percentage of your section. EM and REM are units based on the size of your fonts. You can also do VW, which stands for viewer width. And the next thing I want to do is I want to make sure it's aligned to the left-hand side of my content area. And then next, I want to go ahead and add my header to add in the name for this. So the name of the business is called Faded Memories. And I do want to leave it as an H2 because typically you want to use the H1 for the hero tagline. So I'll show you that here in a second, but Faded Memories, and then I have my camera here as well. And what I want to do is I want to make it so that this camera and this heading are listed on the same line. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select my camera, I'm going to go to the Advanced tab, and I'm going to adjust this width setting right here. Instead of using the default one, let's go ahead and use inline. And then I'm going to do the same for the heading, so that they're both in line. So same thing, I clicked the heading, went to the Advanced tab, and I'm going to adjust the width so now that they're in line. As you can see, it's not exactly how I want it to be. This is way too far up. I want it to be centered with this icon or this logo. So I'm gonna click vertical line center, and that should bring it back down. All right, so I think that looks pretty good, and I'm pretty happy with how that looks right now. Alright, so next section, let's go ahead and make this into two columns. Here's where I'm going to add my hero or my H1 heading. So let's go ahead and make it into an H1, and that's automatically going to pull in my styles. And let me copy paste what I have written already here into the title area. Alright, so it says capture your special day with Faded Memories. So now that we have that set up, let's go ahead and add in a text area to kind of add in more details on what this business does. And since we don't want it to be this big, let's go ahead and switch over from visual to text because it looks like it's bringing in the styles from my notes. So I'm going to replace that really quick. And so now I have my header, I have some text to further explain what the business does. And now I want to add in a button. So a little call to action. When somebody lands on my page, they know exactly what I want them to do. In this case, I want them to book a consultation. And we won't add the link in yet, just yet, because we don't have our booking section ready, but we'll come back to that. And then here on the right-hand column, I wanna go ahead and add an image, just like that. And then we're gonna go ahead and choose our image. So let me upload some of the images that I have prepared for this tutorial. All right, so I'm gonna use this very first one here. Just a sprawl of all the Polaroids. I love how this looks right now, but let's go ahead and center the content of this left-hand column. So I'm gonna click on that. And here we're editing the column, and I don't think I've mentioned this earlier, but if you click on the section, you can edit the section layout, the style, advance as well. And then you can do the same thing for the columns. So in this case, I'm gonna select the column and I want to align it to the middle. So here where it says vertical line, let's choose middle. And so that will make sure it's always going to be centered here in my column. So let's continue onto our next section. Alrighty, so let's go ahead and add in a section to showcase some of the service offerings and information. So I'm gonna add one with three because I have something prepared with three sections. Let's go ahead and add in a heading, a text editor element, and we can also add in an image. And what I wanna do is I wanna click copy. I'm gonna paste into each one. All right, so I accidentally made more than I needed, so I'm gonna delete the ones that are empty. And I'm gonna click delete. So right click onto the column and click delete. All right, so now I have what I was looking for. And what I actually wanna do is make this a little interesting. So kind of like a little zigzag pattern. And then I'm gonna paste in all the content that I have prepared for this. Alrighty, so I think this looks pretty great. The only thing I don't like is that it feels a little uncentered. So I'm gonna do that same thing where I go into each column and just make sure they're all center aligned in the middle. So that, I think that looks a little bit more cohesive. Another thing that kind of bothers me is that I wish there was more space between this hero section and then this section. So what we're going to do is I'm going to select the section and I'm going to go ahead and open the advanced tab. And what I want to do is add in some margin between those sections. So I have it set to pixels. So let's go ahead and add in 100 pixels and see how that looks. So actually I think that looks pretty good. That gives it a little bit more breathing room. And so it also added it to the bottom. So anything I add here below is going to have a little more space as well. And so I like how that looks. So let's continue to the next section. Alrighty, so for this next section, it's gonna be like a little about section. So let's add in two columns. All right, so let's go ahead and drag in our headings here. And what I like to do is I like to stack the headings like this. I think it looks pretty neat. So instead of adding an H2 twice, let's do an H3. I think that looks pretty nice. And then I'm gonna go ahead and add in the text for this section right below it. And I think actually I'll go back and adjust this a little bit. So if I click into the column, I think these are too spaced out. So clicking onto the column, I can edit the space between all the widgets. By default, it's set to 20, but let's try 5. And then on the other column, let's go ahead and add an image. And here's a picture of the photographer. And I'm going to go ahead and center this again. So put that in the middle. Since I already have this kind of layout where the text is on the left and the image is on the right, I think I'm gonna go ahead and swap these. So to do that, you can always drag the column and flip it onto the other side. Now that I have that in place, we've come to our booking section. We're gonna add in a one column section just like that. And because we're using Simply Schedule Appointments, it should have added a brand new widget or element for us to use. So if you just type in appointments, it'll bring up these two new elements. So this one is called an upcoming appointments element and a schedule an appointment. And just to give you a heads up, the upcoming appointments is only for logged in WordPress users. So if you have a membership site where people actually log into your website, they can see their upcoming appointments that they've scheduled with you using this element. But for this tutorial, we're only going to be using the schedule an appointment element, and I'm going to drag it into place just like that. Alrighty. So this is what it looks like by default. And we're going to change the styles here in a little bit, but just to get started, here in the content, it gives you the option to select your appointment type. In this case, we only have one, so all is going to be the same as just selecting this. So I'm going to go ahead and just put that, just in case if I add another calendar, it's not going to automatically get added here, unless I manually add it. So let's make sure that's correct, and then let's move over to the style settings, because right now it's set to green by default. That's just a color that comes with the plugin, but let's go ahead and make some changes here. So our accent color, I want it to be a red, just like that. And then our background color, I want it to match this background. I should have made it a global color, but I didn't. So let me switch over to the site settings really quick and make sure that it's a global color. All right, so background. So here is my global color. And I'm going to go back to the global color settings, and I'm going to go ahead and add a new one. Let's name it the background beige. And then I'm going to add in the hex code for that and update it. All right, so now when we exit our site settings and scroll down to the very bottom and go back to editing our calendar, when we select the background color, we can have our background beige. And I believe it takes a second for that to settle in. After we publish it, it'll start kicking in. But then our font family, let's go ahead and add in our special elite font. I think that looks really cute. And oh, it looks like it kicked in already. And then you can add in padding in case you need more space around this element in general. Alrighty, so I think that looks pretty cute. If I hover over it, I can see the different styles here. And just like that, we have a booking calendar in place to go with our website. Alrighty, so now we'll do our very last section, which is just a little footer with some social links. So let's go ahead and add a brand new section here. And what I want to do is actually change the color of this to give it a little bit more contrast. So clicking on the section, if we go to the styles and click the background types, let's choose a different color. So let's try this blue, and I think that looks pretty good. And what I actually want to do is probably bring in some of the same elements here. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this column and then paste it back in here. All right, so I copied my column in, but I now have this blank column, so I'm going to delete it. And so I have this text, but it's that same exact blue that I have before. So let's go ahead and select that and change the style to have a white, or you can even make it the beige, but I think let's go with white instead. Next, I want to add in some social icons. After there we go. And then we can left align it, and you can go in and change the icon. You can change the color if you want to use a custom color. So let's go ahead and do our light blue for all of these. Add in the links to those from here. Select whether you want rounded, squared, circle. Let's go with circle. And you can choose whether you want to show those into multiple columns or not. And then you can also adjust the style from here, how big these appear. Want to go a little smaller. You can add in the padding between them, rows, gap, etc. You can also change the hover animation and set more advanced settings here as well. And I think the last thing I want to do is probably just add in, oh, I guess the location. So I can drag in a little Google Maps. Yeah, let's just leave it at London. I'll leave it in London. Probably zoom in a little further. I'll just leave the style as is. And you can change the height of this and choose how big it shows up. 274 is fine. And then the last thing I want to do too is I want to give this a little bit more cushion within the blue area. So whereas before we added in the margin, this time let's go ahead and add in some padding. I'm going to unlink the values, and what I want to do is I want to add 100 pixels. That's too much. Let's add in 50. Okay, 50 pixels is good. And then at the very bottom, maybe the bottom we do 100. That's perfectly fine. Now that we've covered every single section in our page, the last thing I want to do is make sure that this book a consultation button is set up correctly. And so what I want to do is I'm going to click into the section where my booking calendar is placed. And what we're going to do is we're going to head over to the advanced section, and then we want to go and add a CSS ID. So we're going to type in anything you want, really, but I'm going to type in booking, and then we're going to scroll all the way up to the top where our button's located, click on our button, and then here where it says link, we're going to leave this pound sign right there, and then we're going to type in booking. And so what that's going to do is anytime somebody clicks on this, it's going to scroll the page down to our booking calendar section. Anyway, so let's go ahead and publish this and see what our page looks like right now. All right, so it says your page is live. Let's have a look. All right, so right now this is what it looks like. So we have our little services area, our about area, and then we have our calendar. So if we click through here, that's what it looks like. And then here's our little footer. And if you ever need to edit anything here, you can always click edit with Elementor. And I think I've also forgot to show you how you can make this responsive. So if you swap or you click on this little responsive mode button here at the very bottom, you can always check out how it looks on tablet and on mobile. So on tablet, this is a little preview of what it looks like. And some things I like to keep in mind too, especially for like sections like this where it's a little more picture heavy or have like pictures involved, sometimes you may need to swap the order of them. So if you click advanced on that specific column and then click on responsive, you can hide some of these elements. You can make sure that they are reversed, for example. You can also go in and start setting different settings. So anything that shows this little tablet icon next to it is something that you can adjust when going down the screen sizes. For example, if I wanted to center these as I start going down in screen sizes, you can see that the alignment has this little tablet. And if I wanted to center it, I can just click on that. But you'll see that my mobile is not affected. Here on mobile, it's still aligned to the left. It's only after I switch to tablet mode that it starts centering it for me. So again, anything that has that little tablet icon, you can adjust for the different screen sizes. So you can see you can change the width, height, etc. And just make sure to give it one last review every single time you make any changes, just to make sure it's still usable and friendly in the different for different devices. Anyway, let's go ahead and update that just so you can see the booking button in action. So if I click book consultation, it drags me all the way to the very bottom and I can start booking my appointment. And once we book an appointment, it will give you a little consultation. Your customer can click the Save to Calendar button and they can add it to Google Calendar, and you have control over what shows up for them. As you can see here, they also have a few other options too, like they can edit information, reschedule, cancel this appointment, or schedule a new one. Scheduling a new one will just take them back to the initial interface. Alrighty, so the last thing we want to do to make sure that this shows up as our homepage every single time somebody visits our website domain, head over to the settings tab and click where it says reading. And from here, it's going to give you a few different settings. For example, it's giving you your homepage displays, and you get to choose whether you want your latest posts to display or if you want a static page. So let's switch over to the static page settings, and where it says homepage, let's choose the page that we had named home. And then I think we're okay to ignore the rest of these settings. When you're done, just click save. So now anytime you visit your homepage or visit the mydomainaddress.com page on its own, it looks just like this. So anytime somebody visits this page or this domain, this is what they're gonna see.